Hollywood loves a good old remake. Star Wars, Star Trek, and even your favorite Disney classics have all gotten a glow up recently. There's one reboot on the horizon that we've got our eye on, Dune. Dune is a sci-fi classic from 1984, and it's based off the 1965 novel of the same name. There are many elements that drive the story of Dune, but the one we're interested in is the Melange, also known as the Spice. In the universe of Dune, the spice comes from a hostile desert planet called Arrakis that is inhabited by colossal sandworms. Gross. It's described as cinnamon-colored reddish-brown. It also smells like bitter cinnamon and tastes like it too. Why would anyone in the world ever try to get through one of those for some of this? Well, that's because the spice isn't just something to put in your latte. It's a powerful drug that lengthens your lifespan, improves your health, and heightens your awareness, granting some people future sight. I've heard kale has similar benefits. Anyway, while we're reasonably sure there aren't any stones that can make us live longer or see into the future, we'll do our best to find some real-life minerals that match the descriptions of the spice in the Dune universe. We'll start with the first thing you notice, the color. It's distinctly reddish-brown and kind of reminds me of the surface of Mars. As we covered in our Watchmen video, click here to watch that one, the surface of Mars gets its red color from iron. The dunes where the spice can be found look a lot like the iron-rich surface of our neighboring planet. So, if we had to start somewhere, I'd say it's a fair guess that it's iron and not cinnamon powder that gives the spice its color. Interestingly enough, the spice also is said to glow blue. Now, do we know any stones that glow blue? If you're familiar with our channel, and hopefully you are by now, you said yes. There are plenty of stones that glow under ultraviolet light, like fluorite and diamond, but the glowing stops when you turn the light off. All right, so what about stones that just keep glowing? Sounds to me like we could be dealing with thermoluminescence. That's when a stone re-emits the electromagnetic energy received from heating as light. This can be seen in some calcite, but the really crazy example is chlorophane. It combines fluorescence, triboluminescence, and phosphorescence, as well as thermoluminescence. It can glow just from the heat of your hand, and there are accounts of stones glowing through the night just from the heat of the sun. I think we have a winner. Now, that's got me satisfied on the visuals. Let's move on to some of the spice's weirder properties. Smell and taste aren't usually the first identifiers when it comes to most gemstones, but that doesn't mean there aren't some tasty, smelly stones out there. Sulfur, for example, is probably the most famous for its smell. At room temperature, sulfur can smell like a lit match, but heat it or strike it and your nose may start to tell you that someone left a carton of eggs out. Gross. The same goes for pyrite, actually. It smells similar to sulfur when struck or heated, which makes sense given that it's an iron sulfide. It's made of our aforementioned iron and sulfur. Not exactly the cinnamon smell we were looking for, but hey, it's something. Moving on to taste. If sulfur is the most famous smell, I'd say halite is the most famous taste. In fact, you've tasted it before. It's the natural form of sodium chloride, rock salt. If you licked a halite formation, you'd be met with a familiar taste of salt, though I wouldn't recommend doing it that way. If you find yourself in a blind mineral taste test, wet your finger, touch the specimen with it, and then lick your finger. That should be enough. And halite in particular is highly water soluble, so don't get too crazy. There aren't too many stones that taste like much of anything, and the payoff isn't exactly cinnamon. So don't go treating the next gravel lot you see like it's lickable wallpaper.
The snozzberries taste like snozzberries.
That sweet alkaline taste you might find could be borax, and the metallic, slightly poisonous flavor may be chalcanthite. Don't do it. And definitely don't go seasoning your steak with freshly grated halite either. I'll find out about it and I'll be disappointed. Next, I want to cover the spice's interesting origins. Unlike most minerals and gems here on Earth that come from time underground and natural processes, the spice comes from the, shall we say, natural processes of those giant worms. More specifically, sand trout. They're basically little sandworm babies, and it's their fungal excretions that, when mixed with water, become a sort of pre-spice mass. This is then blasted to the surface by an explosion of pressure, where it dries out in the intense heat of the Arrakis air. All right, there's our thermoluminescence, becoming the spice we all know and love. When a giant sandworm dies, tons of little sand trout are released into the desert sands, and the cycle continues. You know what they say, either you die a mind-altering drug or you live long enough to see yourself become a giant sandworm. I think that was Gandhi. Anyway, we have some nice animal byproduct here on Earth too. It's called coprolite and it's fossilized poo. If that's what you're into, boy, have we got a video for you. Coprolite gets its name from the Greek words for dung and stone. Like many other fossils, it has had most of its organic composition replaced by mineral deposits. This separates it from paleofeces, which is organic enough that it can be reconstituted to better study what it's made of. Probably a short sign-up sheet for that job. But that's what's so cool about coprolite. It's incredibly useful in learning the diet and predation of some of those ancient animals. And like those ancient animals, some coprolite specimens can be large, like up to 2 feet or 60 centimeters. All right, it looks like if we wanted to create our own spice from what we've got to work with here on Earth, it'd be a glow-in-the-dark melange, get it, of chlorophane, sulfur, iron, salt, and ancient poop. Not exactly apple pie seasoning, but it may be the best we can do. But hey, at least it won't kill you when you stop using it. I'm gonna go grab a mortar and pestle and see what I can come up with. That's all for me today, guys. Before I go, tell me, would you battle a worm 10 times the size of a blue whale for some forbidden cinnamon? Let me know down in the comments and don't forget to like, subscribe, and ring that bell. You don't wanna miss out on our future videos. Thanks for watching.